Hey everybody, Garmin released the eTrex SE a couple weeks ago and I finally got my hands on it, delivered to me via Amazon. This is a honest-to-goodness update of the eTrex 10, which was your entry-level GPS handheld device, bare bones, no mapping, all the basic GPS functions you would need in a handheld device. You would normally find the eTrex 10 in situations where you need inventory, so parks, recreation, schools, search and rescue, anything that you need a group of GPS devices to teach people how to use a GPS, how to navigate, how to use map and compass. This is where we would find the eTrex 10 back in the day, and we haven't seen any updates on this forever. Even the recent update 3 years ago on the 22 and 32X really wasn't much of an update. So glad to see that they're going to refresh the eTrex SE. Lots of new tech, lots more added features on this. So this is why I think this is a pretty good option to take a look at if you want basic bare bones GPS device. Yes, a lot of people use smartphones and apps, but there's still a valid use for this. So let's take a look at the box here. We can see here that we have a Bluetooth icon, which means that we can pair with our smartphone, Garmin Explore, geocaching, notifications, all that fun stuff. Notice we don't have Wi-Fi and we don't have Ant Plus, meaning that we probably can't use this for an InReach remote. Now we can open up the box here and see what's going on. And we have, ta-da, the device itself. Nice, small. That's one of the benefits with these eTrexes, right? Nice, small, fits in your hand. Let's see what else is in the box. No cable, no clips, just a little instruction manual. That's okay. This is why I do these how-to tutorials. So let's take a closer look at this device. So I decided to put the eTrex SE next to a couple of other Garmin devices. First, we have the InReach Messenger, which is a very small device itself. And then I said, well, let's see what else. Do I have anything bigger? I have the Montana 700, which is a very big device compared to it. I don't have the eTrex 22X. I gave it to my brother-in-law, and I don't have my GPS 66. Gave it to my dad. But this reminds me a lot of a previous version, which is DeLorme before Garmin bought them. They had an InReach SE, which I think we're going to see an SE Plus, much like how we saw an SE Plus. Here, I'm going to bring out the InReach or DeLorme or Garmin InReach Explorer Plus. So I'm assuming that we're going to see a replacement for the eTrex 2030, which will be an Explorer. And I think we're going to see a Plus versions, which will have the InReach inside of it. Take a look at the design aspect. You can see here it shares a lot of the design aesthetics with the Garmin Messenger. Luckily, we still have the carabiner clip. But you can see here how it has that nice kind of refined shape here with the buttons and all that. So this tells me that, you know, there's going to be some improvements inside of this device here because how the InReach Messenger was able to do quite a few things specifically with battery. So here we have the up and down buttons here on the left side. We also have the power button here at the top. And we have a little lanyard attachment here at the bottom. We have the backlight, OK, and back button here. Notice here we don't have any power attachments or ports or covers. We're going to open up the battery case here, same as before. There's our USB-C connector. All right, so I decided to pair initially with my iPad tablet, so I'm just going to finish the pairing sequence. It's a very simple sequence. You can do this with your phone. I'll do this in more detail in another video, but I just quickly wanted to connect the eTrex SE to my tablet to get access to the Wi-Fi so that I can add it to my Garmin Explore. And now let's see what's left in this wizard. We can see we have tracking tools. So we can see that we have some tracking and we have access to our map, our compass, and trip data or tracking data from that. And then we have our navigation controls. Basically, we're going to hit on the OK button. We're going to have a little submenu that opens up and we can choose some options. And then we have some button shortcuts, which is the back button, which is, I think they call it in the manual, the glances. But now here's our main page. You can see now that our device is trying to acquire satellites. But let's scroll through the menu here and go on tracking. Let's press OK and see what else we got here. We got our three pages here. This is our map. These entry devices, we don't have a base map installed, so it's just our track and our cursor. Let's press the OK button. You can see we have all sorts of options and controls we can play around with. Let's tap on the back. And if we page down, we have our compass. And you can see here that it's changing. And yes, it is a digital compass, which is a big deal for this entry-level type of device. So this is great. Now, it rebooted on me here because this device was syncing at the same time with my tablet with Garmin Explorer. It was trying to load all my collections. And if you guys know, I've seen a couple of videos, there's an awful lot of collections I have here. So I'm just going to adjust that later on here. But let's go back here to the map and take a look at a couple of the other screens. All right, so I got that all figured out. Now let's go back to our map. Let's scroll down. We got our compass, and the last page is the trip computer or the tracking or the information page here. So let's press on OK, and you can see that we have our tracking controls. We can press on OK on that. We can see that we can stop, pause, save, discard, just like some of the other devices. And let's see what else we have saved, and we have waypoints, courses, activities, collections, and you can see that it's already trying to sync with my Garmin Explorer account, and it's doing a lot of stuff. So this is why you can see here I'm pressing and it's kind of frozen. So I would say when you're setting this up, pay very good attention to Garmin Explorer as to what collections you want to sync, and just let it sit for a couple minutes. As you can see here, that it's going to be trying to do a couple things when you're getting it. It's going to be trying to sync the collections and then trying to push software updates, which there is an update due for this. So anyway, let's go into our geocaching, which now we can connect to our phone. We can register our device with the geocaching live, I think is what it's called. You've seen this in the other videos I've done with the Map 66 and Montana 700, which is great. Map controls, obviously we don't have the base map, but the map page, you will see your track, you will see your cursor, you will see geocaches, waypoints, all the information except the actual map data. And then we have our phone notifications, so which is good. If you have this on handlebars on your bike, you can view your smartphone notifications, which is great. And about that, let's see, you know, this is covering the basic. We're going to be covering all this stuff here in other videos, but you can see here we have our basic navigations, sight and go, which is a big one here, which is good to see. And let's see, let's try to find something else. I really need to bring this outside so I can get my coordinates, so I can see what happens when we do have satellites acquired. Now, before I go outside and get our position, let me press on the power button, see what happens here. Let's press and hold. You can see we have our menu. We can power off, adjust the backlight, mark waypoint, expedition mode. And what else? We have lock buttons. So a lot of options here, which is great. So we can choose to go back. And of course, let me press that again, press and hold. And let me power off the device like that. All right, not too bad, not too bad at all. Now, this eTrex SE doesn't have InReach inside of it. That means that you're going to have to carry on a satellite communicator with you, like an InReach messenger, or you can actually use a ZOLEO. Both will connect to your smartphone individually, and either or, you'll be able to send your messages, and your SE will be able to communicate with your Garmin Explorer. Another big plus is the fact that they've kept the clip attachment, which means that you can go through your drawer with any older Garmin device, take the carabiner clip or other accessories, take it off the old device and snap it back on. So there you go. Now I can have the SE clipped on my backpack or whatever strap. Or if you have different accessories, here's a backpack accessory or a Molly accessory, you can strap this on, you can clip it on, and this is like a Velcro, so your device is on a string. You can also find handlebar attachments, RAM mounts, all this other stuff. So you can put this eTrex SE on anywhere or repurpose older gear that you have from older devices. Now let's take a look at the main menu. We saw there was an edit button, which means that there are some other new features that we can add. We can add pages to our main menu. So tracking, save satellites, and let's go down here. We can do area calculation, geocaching, moon phase, and smartphone notification, projecting waypoints, sight and go, and weather, which means that if you are in an area with cellular data, you can pull weather from your location. You can see here on our display, we are actually got our satellite acquisition, and now we can scroll down our main menu once we've added weather, and now we can actually fetch a forecast. So this will get it based on our location, and it looks like it's gonna take a couple of seconds. Oh, there we go. There's our current weather forecast, and if I hit the pages, I should have a different view of the forecast. And here we go. Here's the next couple hour slices, I believe. And let's see here. Looks like, can I do OK? Press OK to scroll through. Well, that's pretty neat. That's a nice little UI. And then let's see. We have another page, and we have the 5-day outlook. Very similar if you're on the InReach, but obviously this is pulling your phone data. And oh, we have another page here, UV index and all that. Oh, this is actually pretty good. This is pretty good information here. So what I'll do here is I'll focus on each of these functions individually and build out the usual set of how-to videos. Overall, I think this eTrex SC looks pretty good. It seems to pack a lot more punch than the old eTrex 10. The updates in the technology definitely makes it a little bit more feasible. I can see people using this as part of minimalist. So if you're going in areas where your smartphone won't work, you're going to be offline and you just need some basic GPS data, you are a map and compass person, or you have a paper map, or you have offloaded or downloaded map information on Garmin Explorer on your phone, and you have an InReach, you're basically good to go. One of the big features here is the battery life, 168 hours on these AAs. So that is very interesting. And we'll look forward on future videos.